Welcome. It's mid-May. In fact, it's May 19. The Quiff Gold. The fine Colombian makes the night a wonderful thing. I'm Scott Aukerman. I'm your host. Welcome to the show. If you're just coming to the show from the television show, maybe you've seen the show on IFC, the television show. I'm the host of that show. I'm also the host of this show, which is why it's called the same
thing.
Who
cares where they're coming from? Oh, maybe you saw a flyer posted on a telephone pole.
Well, I want to welcome these people and acclimate them to what they're about to hear.
Tell the welcomes individually to every situation.
I'm going
to
have every happenstance that might have happened. So perhaps you stumbled down the street and found an iPhone, and this podcast was loaded in the podcast app.
That's too specific.
Well, it might happen.
Why wouldn't this person return the phone to the rightful owner?
Well, maybe they don't have Find My Phone loaded on it. It's an older model.
That's an easy excuse. People got to look out for each other. I'm the cake boss, the boss of cakes.
That's right.
I have my own show.
Sure.
Where I make a bunch of cakes.
We each have television shows.
That's true.
You've appeared on mine. I have not been invited to appear on yours.
No, you have not. Nor will you be.
Why?
You don't fit in with the whole cake kitchen milieu, if I may use a fancy French term.
Is it because I've never ordered a cake from you? Like, do you have to order a cake to be on your show?
Finally, he figures it out.
So if I go to your store and order a cake, there will be cameras there?
Of course there will be. Here's the thing. You got to come into the shop. You got to say, in a very wooden way, cake boss, I need a specific cake made by you. This is reality television. And then I will say, in a less wooden way, oh, that's going to be tough. I don't know if I can do that. And then I get in a fight with everybody in the cake kitchen. And then we make your cake.
Right. And then do you ever make up with the people in the cake kitchen, or do they just not film that part?
No, they basically come around to my way of thinking always, mm-hmm. and I'm always correct.
Who are these people who work in your cake kitchen?
It's a bunch of drools I got going on in there. These guys, I got to keep on top of them all the time.
Yeah. Why don't you get like one extra person? Then you could maybe get the cake done 1 hour earlier.
I wish I had the time to sit down and do a bunch of job interviews to hire one extra
person.
That's
all it is? It's not the economics?
I don't have the time, Scott Aukerman. How many times must I tell you? I don't have time to tell you again.
And yet you have time to appear on this podcast
very
frequently.
How do I have time to do that?
I don't know.
Boy, oh boy, I'm not good at managing my time, I guess.
Get back to the cake kitchen.
Yeah, I know. Cake kitchen.
Let me explain what's happening. Cake boss.
Cake boss.
A.K.A. Buddy Velastro or Velestro?
Oh, boy, oh, boy. Dish every single time.
I just know you as Cake Boss.
Cake Boss. It's but no, you don't.
It's,
it's Buddy Velastro.
But what?
You know me as Buddy Velastro.
But what?
Why are you saying this to me?
Buddy Velastro. So
yes.
It ends in an O.
That's right, I'm Italian.
Okay, right. Buddy Velastro.
You call me like a Buddy Olestro or something.
do you use Olestra in your cakes ever?
Oh, pretty frequently.
Yeah. Doesn't that give people diarrhea?
Oh, I'd rather not comment on that.
Shouldn't you be called Diarrhea Boss?
Shouldn't I be called that? You smell like a distillery.
Sorry, yes, late night last night.
Yeah,
rap party.
Late night, Hollywood.
We had our CBB TV show rap party. A wonderful time.
Hanging out with, Gabe Kaplan and Peter Marshall, whoever.
How come you didn't come by? Because you've been on the TV show once.
Yeah.
And you're part of the CBB family. Why weren't you there at the rap party?
Oh, I wonder why. I think it was a scheduling conflict that also... I wasn't invited!
You weren't invited? You're
Nobody
part of the
invited
family.
Me. I think I'm part of the family. I feel like this is my Olive Garden.
Are you on the message boards that everyone...
All the time!
CBB family is on?
All the time!
And no one alerted you to this.
No one alerted... Well, oh, believe me. I saw plenty of chatter about it.
Getting a lot of chatter on the boards.
Getting a lot of chatter on the boards.
That's my favorite part of a show like 24, where like someone's in front of a computer and they go, there's a lot of chatter.
I like when they hack into stuff.
Oh, yeah, that's my favorite part,
And
actually.
They're like, we're in there.
I like how time passes. 60 yeah. seconds to every minute.
But you know what? I like that even not married to a show.
Mm-hmm.
Just like time passing.
Just time passages.
I know you're out there. You're just out of sight. Whoa, time passages. Buy me a ticket on the last train home tonight.
I wish I could have joined you in that, but I have never heard any of the lyrics other than time passages.
You don't know Al Stewart?
I've never heard the song before.
It's the year of the cat.
Nope, never heard the song before. All I know is when I was in the theater, that people would constantly say time passages, and
when
so
you're
I just
in the
know
theater,
meaning the you know, I grew up treading the boards.
Ooh. Oh, I, now everything becomes a crystal clear.
The peanut gallery. Well, isn't that what Shakespeare called it?
Yeah, Shakespeare called it the peanut gallery.
What were they called? The peanut gallery. What is it?
What are you talking about?
Those people who would be in the front.
The groundlings?
No, I'm pretty sure it was the peanut gallery. Anyway.
You're probably right.
Why isn't there an improv theater and troupe called the peanut gallery? There's the groundlings. Let's make one called the peanut gallery.
How about the... There's probably a thousand of them.
How about Mr. Peanut's gallery?
Oh, that's copyright infringement, Scott Aukerman.
Still? What if...
Yeah, you know what? Still. Good point. They should do it.
Or what if the Planters Corporation decided to start an improv group and troupe, a group or a troupe, and called it Mr. Peanut's Gallery? See?
You don't think they call it Mixnutch? Of course they would.
Okay, never mind. I rescind. I retract. Now...
On a morning like a Bogart movie.
What is that?
In a country where they turn back time. It's Time Passages by Al Stewart.
I wish I could join in on this. God, this is my greatest regret.
He's got a beautiful, haunting voice.
Really? Haunting like a haunted house?
Well, I urge all the listeners to look up Time Passages by Al Stewart.
Okay.
And you will hear that he's got... It's a wonder he didn't have more hits.
Yeah.
And why isn't he a viable artist today? Because he's got such an amazing voice.
There aren't enough songs sung by ghosts. There's Monster Mash. I can count them on one hand. Monster Mash.
Was that sung by a ghost?
I do remember it was a Graveyard Smash. I don't recall.
That is not up for debate.
No, not in the least.
Absolutely, it's a proven Graveyard Smash.
But I maybe. Oh, it was a guy who was working in the lab, obviously.
So he's a scientist. I think he was.
It could be a ghost, though, like a dead scientist.
Well, you could say that about any show.
I guess so. How many songs are sung in the guise of dead people? You know, like someone saying, I'm dead now, but I remember back when I was alive.
40.
40 songs.
40 songs.
All right. Can you list any of them, listeners?
Yep.
Or you. Yeah, great. What do we got?
Monster Bash, number one with a bullet.
Is that how he died? With a bullet?
Yeah, he was shot in the head.
In the lab?
He knew too much.
Okay, so we got Monster Mash, obviously. Is Cat's Cradle or Cat in the Cradle? Is that sung by a ghost?
Oh, wait, which? How many questions are you asking me?
I can't remember the name of the song. Cat's in the Cradle.
Cat's Cradle.
Is that sung by a ghost?
By a ghost. Dad, at the end of his life, regretting. Too late. You're dead, Dad. You should have played catch with your son. Oh, and then the son dies. So by the end, it's sung by two ghosts.
So they're reunited.
That's a very rare song. That's sung from the point of view of two ghosts.
We call that a tubu. And,
that's right, we do.
And so
the national anthem,
right? So
it's sung by it's sung by a ghost.
The national anthem is okay.
Yes.
Yeah, is that Francis Scott Key as himself as a ghost singing it, or is it just sung by a patriotic ghost?
It's sung by the ghost of the Apostle Peter.
Okay, now the Ballad of Billie Jean. Is that sung by a ghost?
That's sung to a ghost.
To a ghost. Okay, so that's a new twist on
that's
an old
a new
favorite.
Twist. No, no, no. Oh, you said it.
Oh. And what about The Devil Went Down to Georgia? Is that a ghost?
That is sung by Almighty God.
Right, because he's viewing the devil trying to trick.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Thinking about that song recently.
Yeah.
The Devil Went Down to Georgia.
Right.
The idea is he's in a bind. He's way behind, and he's looking to make a deal. Who's his boss?
I know. Like, you're the boss of cakes.
Yeah, that's right.
So, but who is the devil's boss?
Yeah,
exactly.
Who's he answering to?
And how? Why does he have to make so many deals? He has a quota to fill?
And also, why does he he's Satan. Why does he stick to his word like, hey, you won?
Right. And here's another thing.
He's a gold fiddle.
Why is he going down to Georgia? Is that implying that the devil is never in Georgia?
Exactly. And also, down to from where?
Exactly. There are a lot of unanswered questions in this because...
I would imagine the redneck that wrote that, he's like, the devil lives in New York City or whatever.
Yeah, I bet.
Which he's not far off, I say that. It's a New Jersey guy. New York is like a hell.
Very good, very good.
Very good.
Very, very, very good. Good.
Very,
very extremely good.
Extremely good.
Marvelous.
Marvelous.
Yes.
You look marvelous.
Hey.
Billy Crystal.
Do you think Billy Crystal's song, You Look Marvelous, was sung by a ghost?
It is now.
Yes, because he's
Fernando Lamas dead.
Is dead. But wasn't he dead when that song... When did Fernando Lamas die? Pass away. I'm sorry. R.I.P. R.I.P. R.I. Possible. Is he even dead?
I think he's dead.
Cody, well, let's look this up. Fernando Lamas.
I think if he were alive, he'd be in his hundreds.
R.I. Possible. Would he be in his hundreds? Was he... When did he
he'd
die?
He'd probably be 150.
Was he dead when... Cody, what do we got?
1982.
He died in 82, so
but
that song is
out.
That song is sung by a ghost.
Sung by a ghost.
Because that song came out in 1986, I believe.
Why do you know that?
Because I bought the album in 1986. You look marvelous.
You look marvelous.
You're pretty good. Do you do
it's
any
better to look good than to feel good.
Madonna.
Delroy Lindo.
Marlis.
Is that a thing he should?
Delroy Lindo, marvelous. Her belly button is absolutely marvelous.
The Magna Carta. What are the things that he said?
Marvelous. The Louisiana Purchase, marvelous.
A tornado,
marvelous. Sharknado, marvelous. If you have no idea what we're talking about,
good. Go fuck yourself.
Oh, strong words.
You know, I like to get a little blue on this show.
I understand. It's a temptation. We try to stay away from that kind of language on this show, but sometimes it slips out.
Anticipation.
I don't know that one.
Why did temptation make me think of that? Anything with Asian, I guess.
I guess so. Buddy. Can I call you Buddy?
I wish you would.
Or do you need...
What's my last name?
Vilisok.
What? No. That's the made-up words.
I've heard that word before. I thought.
No,
about,
you haven't. You're,
I thought it was about
you're
you.
You're funning me.
I'm not. I've heard that. Is that... That is a name, right?
That's Vilisok? A bunch of made-up syllables.
I guess so. Maybe you're right. Okay. I have enough trouble saying the name of this show. Comedy Bang...
Why do you think that you have brain damage?
I think I might be. I think something happened
to
me.
You think you might be have brain damage?
I think I might be have brain damage.
You're making a very strong case.
Something happened to me around the third year of this show. I don't think I ever recovered. I think I might actually be dead, too.
Do you think you're a ghost? No, I would know.
I might be a ghost. Like Jason Mantzoukas and I might be ghosts.
Hold on a second.
Yeah.
I would know if you're a ghost, because you know I have supernatural powers.
Oh, that's right. For new listeners of the show, Cake Boss, you never really talk about it on the TV show.
No, well, who will be interested in that?
But
people that watch the show, what they want to see is people making cakes under a very strict time deadline.
Under duress.
Under duress, that's right.
Duress cakes.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
That's right. So you don't get into your supernatural powers a lot, but we've talked about
it. No, it's boring.
Quite a bit on this show.
It's a humdrum routine. I got bit by a cake bug in the cake kitchen, and that gave me the gift of the second sight.
Which means you can communicate with dead people.
No, I can see into the future.
Sorry. Oh, that's right. Oh, okay. That's right. That's what that is. You can see into the future.
Oh, boy.
You've been bitten by so many cake things that it's hard to keep
true.
It straight.
Cake things. I got bit by a cake scarab. When I was making a pyramid cake.
Right.
And
that was going to serve as a mausoleum of sorts
for the
purchaser.
An eccentric millionaire.
Did we ever talk about who that millionaire was?
No, we did not.
Okay.
Would you like to know?
I would like to know.
It was Donald Sterling.
Wow.
Yep.
Was he ever buried inside that cake?
No, he is unfortunately still alive, but, fingers crossed.
So at the time, he was an eccentric millionaire, but since then, he's become an eccentric billionaire.
That's right.
Wow.
Yeah. So I guess you can afford to let a whole two-scale pyramid cake rot.
I guess so. Yeah. So get back to your powers. You were bitten by a cake scarab, which gave you...
That gave me the ability to communicate with the dead, both actual people who have died and fictional characters.
Who have died in the works of fiction.
Who have died in the works of fiction, or it is reasonable to assume that they would be dead by now.
I.e. Huck Finn.
Huckleberry Finn. There's no way he'd still be alive.
There's no way.
I could talk to him.
Sure. Okay. So, and then you were also bitten by a cake wolf, I remember.
Yes, which caused me to transform into a cake wolf.
Right, yeah.
Every full moon.
Pretty simple.
Yeah.
But I want to get back to the cake scarab powers, the powers to communicate
sure.
with the dead.
I mean, can you imagine anyone is interested in this?
Well, I think so, because this is one of the reasons why I wanted to have you on the show, because
sure.
this is very timely and very topical. We got a lot of chatter. About something
on the computer?
Yes, about something that happened in the Star Wars universe recently.
Oh, here we go.
Because on one of your previous appearances, you communicated with Chewbacca.
Yes.
Because Chewbacca died in one of the Star Wars novels.
That's right.
Which at the time was canonical.
True.
Now, the Star Wars, who owns it? Mattel? Who owns Star
Disney.
Wars? Disney. Okay. Disney.
Mattel.
By the way, Mattel, when are they going to change their logo?
Who owns Star Wars? Is it Arthur Treacher's Fish and Chips?
But
is it Garanimals? Who owns Star Wars?
But Mattel, seriously, like, look at their logo. It's been the same for 58 years. You know what I mean? It's just that red star and then the lettering on it.
I can't even picture it in my mind.
You can't picture it? Let me look it up and I'll
sure, look it up.
Look it up and we'll figure this out. But freshen it up.
Why?
Well, everyone freshens up their logos once in a while.
Maybe
they
shouldn't.
Check that out.
Yeah, that's a good, what's wrong with that logo?
It looks so old to me. Like the font on it. It's like change the font or something. I just don't get it.
I think it's a nice logo, and I think why not stay with it?
All right. Okay. You've convinced me. So in any case—
I knew that would work.
Mattel owns
They do
Star
not
Wars.
Own Star Wars. Stop saying that.
Okay. Sorry. But Marvel owns Star Wars? I don't know. Something—
I just told you that it's Disney.
Disney. Oh, Walt Disney.
Yeah. He owns it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
When you say Disney, you're talking about Walt Disney.
Of course.
Walter Disney.
That's right.
The inventor of Mickey Mouse.
That's right. He invented him, gave him life.
So
the enemy of Mrs. whatever they was.
Mrs. Poppins? Mr. Banks?
Mrs. Pelham? What was her name?
Travers.
Travers. P.L. Travers.
Yeah, just like...
that's right.
Yeah. So...
Just like what?
I don't know.
Peter Travers?
Yes, that's what I was going to say. But then
hey, are they related?
Do you think Peter Travers liked that movie?
Did she write for Rolling Stone?
Do you think he was like, hey, finally, a movie about mom? What are we talking about? Oh, we're talking about...
Chewbacca.
Okay, so the people...
Disney owned Star Wars.
Star Wars came out, and because they're making... the Star Wars people came out in the press, and because they're making
They're
new,
all gay?
Because they're making new Star Wars films that presumably will have Chewbacca in them. As a matter of fact, I believe Peter Mayhew was confirmed to be in these films.
Oh, thank God.
They have come out and said
that— Do you think that was a tough negotiation?
He wanted a stack of money as tall as him.
Oh, that's a lot of money.
Yeah.
He's a tall guy.
They're like, hey, we're willing to give you one as tall as, you know, Anthony Daniels, but— So they said because these movies are coming out, now all of the things that were once canonical, I forget what the term of it is, Star Wars Universe or Star Wars, I forget, Expanded Universe, yes, Expanded Universe. All of these things that were once canonical are now no longer canonical. So now it's just the movies are canonical, I guess. Is Splinter of the Mind's Eye canonical anymore?
Oh, you know what? In that movie, in that book written by Alan Dean Foster.
Right.
Splinter of the Mind's Eye. Luke and Leia, they share a romantic moment.
That's pretty sexy, isn't it? When you think about it in hindsight.
That it's incest?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that it's best?
I hear you, brother.
Hey. But so I guess even Splinter of the Mind's Eye, which is one of the first non-movie related things, is new. I wonder if the novels are canonical anymore. Like the George Lucas wrote the original Star Wars novel, the adaptation of his screenplay.
It's pretty much the same as the...
No, there's all sorts of stuff that are no. I wonder if the deleted scenes from Star Wars are canonical with Wedge and, you know, Wedge Antilles and all these people. Anyway.
Well, hold on a second. Yeah. So you're telling me that the Chewbacca died in one of the Star Trek novels?
Star Wars, but yes.
Star Wars.
Who's drunk now?
I am a little bit drunk.
Good. How many episodes are you drunk during of your show?
50%.
50%. Okay,
yeah.
Good. Yeah.
Look, it's very stressful.
But also, you're 50% not drunk.
That's right. Hey, thank you.
Yeah. So
that's a great way to look at it.
So Chewbacca died in one of the offshoot novels.
Yeah.
He had a very heroic death for a Wookiee.
Oh, I thought he got hit by a car.
That's right. Well, I mean, for a Wookiee, I mean, it was very heroic. So he died in one of the novels. You were able to communicate with him, and we had a very touching conversation with him.
We really did. It was beautiful.
And now... It's no longer canonical that he's dead, although maybe presumably he's dead because it was a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. But at the same time, we don't know how long Wookiees live.
But if he's
what is their lifespan?
If he's in these 200
two years,
I think. 2 years.
Wookiees live 200 years.
Yeah.
But is that canonical? Because it's never said in the movies.
But if these,
so it's no, that's no longer canonical. Everything's up for grabs. Is what I'm trying to say.
So hold on a second. But I did communicate.
You did.
With the spirit of Chewbacca.
But can you any longer? Or is your previous appearance not canonical to our show anymore?
I'm feeling very strange.
Yeah, really?
Well, it's I don't know, something about this being declared non-canonical, but I did communicate with him. But if he's in the new movies, then he's alive.
Right. Are you all right?
Yeah, I feel a little... I feel strange.
You feel strange? Really? I mean...
Never felt like this before. It's very strange.
You think it's because you just received this news about...
I feel like it's got to have something to do with it.
Okay. Well, is there anything I can do for you? Can I...
No. You know what? I'm gonna send a text to a friend of mine.
Okay.
This is a just-in-case kind of thing, okay?
Okay.
I think I'm going to be all right, but...
Someone's going to come pick you up? Is that what you're saying?
In a matter of speaking, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Don't you worry about it. It's none of your business.
Oh, all right. Well, send your text. In the meantime, I just want to welcome everyone back.
What's
to the...
address here? Okay. And shed.
Send. Great.
Okay.
Okay. So in any case, I just want to say, hey, everyone, welcome to the show. And
hey, everyone, welcome to the show.
Welcome back to it, or welcome to it if you started this podcast in the middle.
Welcome to you.
Welcome to you. Are you okay? I'm not good. I feel like I need to do something here for you.
Maybe you could shut up.
All right.
That would help. Oof. Yeah, I feel... You ever get that feeling where it's like your limbs are not your own, like they belong to somebody else?
Like you're a doll and someone took off your arms and legs and attached different doll parts on you or something?
Boy, that's very specific. So you're a doll.
Sure.
But you're self-aware.
Sure, you're sentient.
And so somebody has...
Much like your R2-D2 cake.
Boom, mashaka bell. That was a disaster.
Yeah.
So you're a doll. Somebody plucks off your arms, your legs. They put other doll arms and legs on you.
Sure.
And then you, as the doll, you're like, oh, this feels weird.
Sure. I mean, and sometimes it's a good thing. Like you get like Hulk Hogan doll arms on
sure.
you and you can lift, you know... You're in a better weight class.
Yeah, you have the proportionate doll strength
sure.
to a Hulk Hogan doll.
Yes, of course. So sometimes it's a good thing, but most of the time you're a mutant doll that has just different odd parts on
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I guess I feel like that mutant doll.
Yeah, do you? I'm so sorry.
Yeah, thank you. I accept your apology.
So what? Right now you're gesticulating wildly.
Yeah, I don't know what that's all about.
Why are you doing that?
I'm not trying to do it.
Why are you waving at me?
I'm not trying to wave at you. It's like somebody else is trying to say hello to you.
What do you mean? Why are you waving at me right now?
I don't want to be back.
What? Hello?
Hello.
Who's Buddy, what are you...
Nobody.
Nobody?
I'm not your pal, nobody. How did I get here?
Who?
My name is H.R. Giger.
H.R. Giger, the recently deceased artist?
Yes, the proudly deceased. I don't want to be... I'm a narco sculptor.
Yes, you're a narco... You're the author of the narco...
Necronomicon.
Necronomicon.
Yes, and I am not meant for this world. I had gone on. I think that's the way I would have wanted it.
Wait a minute. This is insane, because you're in Buddy Velastro's body currently.
Oh, am I?
Yes. And yet your voice...
Yeah.
You sound exactly like H.R. Giger.
That is who I am. Channeling, no doubt brought back to right some wrongs.
Oh.
Finish unfinished business.
Okay, so let me explain who you are.
Yes.
If you don't know who H.R. Giger is, you're an artist, a narco artist.
Narco sculptor.
Narco sculptor. What does that mean?
I sculpt the dead.
Okay.
And if they're not dead, they are when I'm done with them.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you are, most famously, you created the alien in the movie series Alien
the
and
Xenomorph.
Aliens. The
yes.
Xenomorph, of course, yes. You passed away last week, didn't
yes,
you?
I just did. And I go to heavens. There's women's there.
Uh-huh.
Make me suffering, the women's. They're no segregate, so I go down to hell.
Okay.
And I say to Mr. Devil, you're the devil. Can I work for you? And he says, let me see your work. I show him my paintings, Necronomicon 1-4,
mm-hmm.
one of a lady just getting fucked in half with something that looks like a vacuum hose.
Okay, great.
And he says, that'll do, pig. And then I'm hired, okay?
Okay.
And then... I guess here I am. I was so happy.
Did the devil have to check with his boss?
Yes, he went back. I died in Georgia.
He had to kick it upstairs?
Yeah, I died in Georgia. Bad deal. Long story.
Okay, gosh.
Yeah.
I didn't know you died in Georgia. I knew you were Swiss.
It's just a crazy vacation, last minute sort of Thelma and Louise thing, but. That's how it went down. So now I think I have to figure out my quest before I can go home.
Okay, so wait a minute. You are working for Hell currently?
Hell Incorporated.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a big business down there now.
Okay. So when you say you have to finish unfinished business before you go home, where is home?
Hell.
Okay, so you want to go to hell?
Absolutely. I've been hired as the art director for hell because it was like still Dante-type stuff down there.
It was looking a little dated.
I think. And so I put new spin on it. Everybody seems much happier, or the opposite of happy, but the same correlation.
Sure.
Yeah, it's successful, no doubt.
Yeah, successful in your work. So what unfinished business do you have before you go returneth to hell?
I don't know. I'm trying to figure out. Probably something to do with my wife, Carmen Maria Schiffele Giger. My wife.
Your what?
Wife.
What?
Please don't joke because... The laughter is the enemy of creativity.
Oh, that's right. If people don't know your aesthetic,
yeah,
it's very dark.
Yes.
Your favorite color
is no color. The absence of color.
The absence of color.
Black, varicose, bruise, cloud, whatever.
Mm-hmm. You're in Buddy Velastro's body currently, the cake boss. He's not saying cake boss. Interesting.
Cake. Boss. Oh.
Wait, did Buddy just retain his sentience just to say cake boss?
He is a bit like a whale or a sea mammal where every so once in a while he has to come up for a cake boss air.
you're a very dark artist. You passed away in Georgia, and I hear it was the result of complications due to like some sort of Chewbacca-style car crash? Was that what it was?
Yes, that's exactly right. And it is honorable in both Wookiee species and narco sculptors to be hit by a car.
Do you regret doing the designs? Well, I have you here, by the way, if I could ask you a few questions.
By all means, first I want to say just two things.
Yes.
Great to be here.
Okay, thank you.
And also, wouldn't it be great if our rib cages were a second articulating mandible jaw that we could vanquish our foes with?
I love your ideas.
Those
and this is what your art is all about. But do you regret making the designs for the Alien series and not Star Wars?
Oh, well,
I think Chewbacca would be so much more interesting if you had designed
it. Yeah, all that fur gets in the way. I think better to have someone with a bisected rib tube and lots of darkness, blood. Exoskeletons are the new endoskeletons. Mm, you know?
Of course, yeah. Do you? Darth Vader is maybe the closest to what
he's
you do.
He's a pussy.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Like, well, how would you do Darth Vader differently?
Well, no samurai-looking armor, because mine would be biomechanical, come natural. If he needs to buy it, who among us cannot be Darth Vader?
Mm.
This chosen few with an exoskeleton, those are the men we put on our shoulders of giants.
Mm.
You're on my mind like a song on the radio. Al Stewart. Great artist.
You're an Al Stewart fan.
Who isn't?
Oh. Why do you think that you're possessing the body of Buddy Velastro, the cake boss?
I think the way it's explained to me by the devil.
He didn't say cake boss again. Interesting.
Cake boss women's. Is that it has to be a yin-yang matter-antimatter, where cake boss brings joy into cake boss brings joy into the life of many people. My goal is to take it away. Mm. And if I were to, say, go into Morrissey or Hieronymus Bosch, the universe would implode. Cake boss. Mm. Implode.
So the theory then is that cake boss is the happiest person who brings the most joy to people in the world.
Cake boss. It is no theory. It is a proven fact. So,
his cakes are just amazing, and they the smiles and the faces that light up when one sees them.
Yeah. They make me happy, which in turn makes me sad.
Very good.
Which then that makes me happy.
Mm,
and
okay.
It is a negative feedback loop. I started doing paintings because for therapy, for I had night terrors. And this is true. Mm. And so then I did paintings of my night terrors, which gave me greater night terrors, which gave me greater paintings. And that's how I became all powerful.
Why did you keep your paintings right above your bed? Did you? I read that you put them on the ceiling as well, so you could stare at them right before you went to bed.
That's true. I painted them there on the wall. I didn't even hang them there.
Sort of like a Michelangelo kind of alfresco thing?
Yeah, it was the agony, and there was no ecstasy because I would not have it.
Mm.
Now listen.
Oh, okay. Yes, master.
I also made my own bed out of the ossified skin leather of a lesser race.
Oh my god. Well, I guess you have to lie in it.
Yeah.
If you made your own bed.
You do. Listen, we don't have to talk about that.
Mike, so this is so interesting to me because I had expected to do a show with Buddy Velastro.
Who?
Cake boss.
Boss.
Wow, you preempted me a little bit.
I didn't, he did.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I expected to do the entire show with him, but now I have H.R. Giger, with whom I've never spoken. I've always wanted to. I've been a big fan of your work ever since I was 9 years old and the Alien movie came out. And
Xenomorph,
yeah, of course.
Yeah. Facehugger.
Facehugger,
yeah.
Of course. Did you see Prometheus?
Yeah, that was shit. I mean, I worked on it and all, but I do not sanction it.
Mm, okay. What about
too many questions?
Yeah.
Not enough answers.
It's like you're supposed to answer questions, not answer a couple and then raise a whole bunch more.
See, girlfriend, because I am an artist and I should be like all about questions.
Mm.
But even that was bullshit because I don't think they have the answers themselves.
Yeah.
And who are those Statue of Liberty looking motherfuckers?
Yeah, exactly. Did you see Grown Ups 2?
Oh, I own it. I did the production design.
You did on Grown Ups too.
Yeah, under us.
You did the whole general feeling about it.
I production.
And you did
design.
Perception about it.
Yeah, I production designed its general reception.
Yes.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I think it's my finest work.
Yeah, I really
do. It's so good. Oh God.
Oh. So my goodness. Well, the world lost a great artist.
Who?
But you.
Oh yeah. Oh, jeez, I got frightened.
Why? Who's your favorite artist? The painter
Norman
of light?
Norman Rockwell.
Oh.
And yes, Thomas Kincaid.
Oh,
he's
yeah.
dead too.
He
and
is.
I've got to have a great time with him.
Is he down in hell?
Oh dear. He's running shit down there.
Really?
Let me tell you. He was a drinker, to be sure.
Mm.
And so we've thrown back some fire mead.
Mm.
And
are you drunk right? I mean, a buddy's drunk. Does that make you drunk?
Yeah, I'm 50% drunk right now.
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
I don't normally drink because it brings out the angels in me, and I don't like, not the demons. Do you see how I'm an opposite guy?
Yeah, I get, no, I understand your game.
That's part of my deal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're a great artist. Yeah. The world lost you. It's such a shame. We just recently lost you, but it's such a pleasure to talk to you. I really want to take the most of this opportunity because we've never spoken before. We've never had you on the show. So I just want to sit down and really bring out your actor's pain in you and just, you know, I mean.
Who's that?
Who's knocking on the door? Who's it? Hello, sir.
Oh, I already don't like you.
Who's?
Yes, hello there.
Hello,
you,
sir.
Are you Scott Aukerman?
Yeah, I'm Scott Aukerman.
I received a text on my mobile phone for said, come down to this place and talk to a Scott Aukerman.
I thought that he was just pronouncing it that way. He typed it that way?
Are you talking about my friend, Mr. Velastro?
Yes, your friend who's right next to you.
Cake,
here.
Yes.
Oh, what? Buddy, are you in there?
No, Buddy's gone from this place.
Oh, it's happened. He was worried that this would happen someday.
Worried? What would happen?
Well, let me tell you who I am. My name is the Reverend Robert Persimony, and I am an exorcist.
Oh, like the movie The Exorcist?
What's that?
A famous film series.
Like Grown Ups?
A lot like Grown Ups.
You know my work.
Wait a minute. Now you look like my friend, but I feel as if you're being taken over by a strange spirit. Is that true?
Buddy Velastro is dead. You will not find him here.
Well, who are you? Speak to me, demon.
I am H.R. Giger, born Hans Rudolf Giger, but my spiritual moniker is Hey Really Giger.
Wait, are you the Sid and Marty Croft puppet guy?
No, not H.R. Puffinstuff.
I could I'm sorry. You make that mistake.
Oh, well, you understand. Yes, yeah. Of course.
I did do some more.
Two famous HRs, huh?
Yeah. How many more are there, do you think?
Just human resources.
Yep, that's it.
That's it.
Well, that's done and dusted.
No, that's number one with a bullet.
You know, so far this is not so bad. This exorcism.
Well, I haven't even started yet. When I'm going to exorcise you, you'll know it.
Don't threaten me.
I want to get the lay of the land here. I've done over 40 exorcisms
over
in my
40?
Career. Yes,
how
that's
many?
Right. 41. Mm. And all of them went off pretty much without a hitch. Very few resulted in...
You ever see that movie Hitch, by the way, HR?
Oh, sure. Will Smith is one of our great treasures.
It also stars one of the stars of Grown Ups, Kevin James.
Yeah. Frequent collaborator.
And Grown Ups, too.
There's a second one?
There is.
Oh, I can't wait.
How did you know it was a film series without knowing?
I just assumed that there would be. I was waiting for it to come out.
I was a consultant on Mall Blart.
Paul Blart.
Oh, listen, I didn't write it. Okay?
Are you saying, were you under the impression that his occupation was Mall Blart?
So it was Paul Blart, Mall Blart.
Yes. Originally conceived, and it would have been something.
Help wanted, Mall Blart.
Goddamn studios again.
Now look here, you're not going to distract me, you demon. I want to find out all about you.
What was your name, by the way, sir?
Reverend Robert Persimony.
Robert Persimony. Welcome to the show.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
We've never spoken before. My name is Scott Aukerman. Scott Aukerman.
Aukerman.
But you know how Buddy speaks.
Yes, I do.
I assumed that was just his dialect.
He's from New Jersey, so
certainly.
He has a curious
dialect. Where are you from?
Dialect. Oh, I'm from the Middle West.
Hmm. And how did you guys get to know each other?
Well, I have I moved my parish. I have a parish out here.
Perish the thought.
I'm a bi-coastal man of the cloth, and I have a parish here and a parish in New Jersey, and then I also have a parish in Iowa.
Mm. I'm still here.
Yes. Well, now, what has caused you, demon, to take over the form of my friend?
I have had to do unfinished business on the earthly realm.
What is this business, spirit? Speak to it.
Something to do with women, for I am afeard of them. They make me have a qualm. My heart turns into a squall.
Now, how do you expect taking over my friend's body, who's a married man, by the way? So,
don't go off and try to like have sex with any other women because you...
I really should be getting home to New Jersey.
Wait a minute! What? No, I forbid you to take my friend's body back to New Jersey. You will remain here, and then I will cast you out, and I will condemn you to a lake of fire.
Is there any way to make sure that he doesn't leave the room? Maybe a circle of some sort.
Let me just get the door.
Oh, okay. Yeah, just lock it.
There we go.
I'm a little confused. Why did Buddy think this was going to happen? How did he know what was happening to him?
Well, he knew when he was cursed by Satan himself with these supernatural powers that
What's
are against
that?
God, by the way. Make no mistake, they're against God. Yeah. The only person who can see into the future is God, and he's not telling anybody. Hmm. He's keeping it to himself.
So wait, is the devil went down to Georgia? Is that the future?
Yes,
since
that's
God,
correct.
God is narrating that song. Is
yes,
it's
eventually,
set in the future.
Eventually, when God dies and the devil has a new boss.
Right. Okay. So he knew that he was cursed by Satan, and so he thought he would be taken.
Well, he doesn't see it that way. I certainly see it that way. His powers are unearthly and unnatural and the uncola. And I feel that.
Set it up.
There's a cola nut, crisp and clean, no caffeine. Never had it and never will. He feels that these powers are also a gift, but I feel that they're nothing but a curse, from hell itself.
So he thinks his powers are a gift, and yet he thought that he would have his body taken over by
He thought there was a possibility if things became non-canonical in any way. He's very concerned with canon.
Okay, now we're getting to it. So he sent that text to you, and you're here to protect him.
He said, let me read his text here. Reverend, am feeling queasy. Q-U-E-E-C-Y.
Mm-hmm. You were able to interpret that as queasy, though.
Come to Earwolf. He was typing very fast.
No, I think that's just his dialect coming through his thumbs.
I'm on a podcast.
How did he spell that?
P-O-D-C-A-S-H-T.
Great.
Contact there. Scott Aukerman. A-U-X-E-R-M-I-N.
Mm. Okay, a lot of people spell that as O-X-E. R-M-A-N. So that's the official the official canonical spelling of it?
How do you spell it?
I never knew. I just had heard it pronounced. But anytime people talk about it on Twitter, that's
Well, it's your name. How do you spell it?
A-U-K-E-R-M-A-N.
Well, where's the X?
That's the point, yeah. In any case, so he asked you to come to protect
him. He knew. Shut up, son. He knew that there would be a time when this might happen and he might need my exorcistal services.
Well, this is exciting. Are we going to see, am I going to see and then the listener's going to hear a live exorcism on the show?
You will see it. The listeners will hear it if you keep recording.
I will also hear it, I would imagine.
You will hear it as well as see it. The listener will not see. They will only hear.
I would imagine I would also feel the vibrations of the sound and any kind of loud noises and stuff.
Should we get into all the senses?
You will
smell whatever is occurring in the room at the time.
Is it going to smell bad?
No.
Or poorly?
Well, that was a close one. There shouldn't
thank
be
God
any smells.
That. Okay, what is going to happen to me?
Oh, I forgot you were still here.
Yeah, I know.
That's right. Tell you what, we need to take a break.
Oh, certainly.
But
gotta pay the bills.
Sure.
So, pass the collection plate around.
So you're okay.
My language, yeah.
You're okay with taking a break before
absolutely.
We do this. There's no rush on this.
No,
right?
No rush. Yeah, I can cast him into a lake of fire anytime.
Okay, so let's.
And I'm good too.
You're good too.
I got until 12:30.
Well, we locked the door.
Half past the witching hour.
Half past the monkey's ass as well.
Ooh,
quarter to his balls, I believe.
Watch your language, please.
All right.
Fudge corner.
Oh, you watch your language.
Okay.
All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, an exciting exorcism on the show. I believe this is the first one.
Don't build it up.
Oh, okay, well, an exorcism, which is exciting to me.
Get my tools together.
If this is your first time listening to the show, normally it's just an interview show. We get to the heart of the matter with several celebrities. I plan to have that type of show with Cake Boss today. We were going to talk a lot about his kitchen.
Cake Boss!
Oh, okay, but just to recap... Very briefly, Cake Boss was possessed by the spirit of the recently deceased H.R. Giger, artist extraordinaire, creator of the alien xenomorph. And then Reverend Robert
Parsimony.
Robert Parsimony Buddy's friend was texted and came in to perform an exorcism.
That's correct. That's correct.
Let's get to this.
Now, I'm a man of the cloth, and I've performed many exorcisms.
Reverend is not Catholic, is it, or is it?
No, I'm a Protestant. I'm not a Catholic. Oh. Catholic Church, of course, the great whore of Babylon. So, not one of those God fearing Christian, and I do fear God. He is terrifying, and you better watch your step, buddy.
Do you fear the devil more or God? God more.
Oh, really? Oh, certainly. Well, I'm a religious man, so I have no fear of the devil. But God, boy, oh boy, you gotta mind your P's and Q's, Mister. He'll smite the hell out of you. He'll just put his fist down on you and squash you like a bug.
Who's the last person that God smited?
Chewbacca.
Who, Baca?
Chewbacca.
Chewbacca's not dead.
Well, you can still survive a smite, you know.
That's true.
Yeah.
All right, so what are we? You've been gathering your tools. What do you have?
Yes,
there?
I have my. Let's see. I have my holy water right here. Mm-hmm. I have my protective goggles.
A lot like this is you can't do that on television or something.
Yes, it's like that. I also have some slime.
So do I.
That's to celebrate after the exorcism. We pour it over our heads. It's fun.
Yeah, you have the Nickelodeon slime, and H.R. Giger, you have the alien slime.
Yeah, the sort of black obsidian slime that mm-hmm. is more of a plot device than
we're
going to
have a slime off.
Son, I don't suppose you have any Ghostbuster slime on you, do you?
Yes, I have my cup of slime here. So
I also have plenty of sharpened number two pencils.
Okay.
That's for taking notes. Mm-hmm. I have my moleskin notebook, of course.
You also have one of those like foot measurers that you get in like a Stride Right.
Yes, I thought it was a credit card machine.
sure.
But
wait, does someone have to pay you for this?
Oh yes, indeed. It's very dear.
Paying? Does Buddy when he's gone? Does Buddy me. Take
well,
out?
Well, I'll leave you two to hash that out. But
maybe we'll split it.
Yeah. You go Dutch on an exorcism, sure. Well, so it's heavy business, and I just put on my gloves here.
All right.
I'm growing stronger.
Fix the snaps. Are you really, boy? That's not good for me.
No, but listen, what am I going to happen to me again?
You're going to be cast into the pit of hell.
So this is a win-win for both of us. I'm going to work with you. I'm not saying this is going to be easy, but I'm with you.
Because
I want to do
HR
this.
Wants to go back to hell.
Yeah, you will be helping.
Oh. Well, this is interesting.
It's interesting because you don't want to give a spirit. You don't want to give them what they want necessarily.
But
no,
if it serves
I certainly
your purpose,
don't.
What's the problem?
I think it might be good to make you wait a little bit because I think you should have some
punish.
Sort of punish. To punish, exactly, much like God would punish all of us.
Sure, yeah, okay.
I really want to go to heaven and just have daisies.
Now you're trying reverse psychology
I
on me, and
know.
That's science, which I don't want any part of.
Mm. So I think we should get to this exorcism, don't you think? I mean,
I think let's wait a minute.
Let's wait a bit. Okay. What do you want to do while we wait?
I don't know. You want to play a game?
Okay, sure. Yeah. Why don't we play a game? Why don't we play a game, a little something that we like to call Riddle Me This. Boom, 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 boom. Riddler. All right, welcome to Riddle Me This. This is a great game that we have. We've been playing it recently on the show, and it's where we'll all take turns. Everyone gets to partake in the fun, so don't you worry about that.
Even the demon?
Even the demon, yes, HR. Would you consider yourself a demon or a recently deceased person who is just happens to be inhabiting a body?
I'm a demicorporeal, surfaceable phantasm,
okay.
I think.
Okay, good.
Read demon.
Okay, take it easy, old
I said
man.
That in parentheses. I may be old, but I'm full of fire and brimstone.
You guys have like an odd couple type thing going on. Like you're
I suppose so, yes.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun to watch.
I'm listening, studio Phoenix? Executives. We're taking meetings.
When you said I'm listening, I thought you were doing a Frasier reference.
Tossed salad on the piano. Al Stewart, great treasure.
Great
treasure.
I love Al Stewart. Time passages.
You guys have a lot in common.
I suppose we do.
Underneath the surface.
Felix and Oscar were both divorced.
Down to Ensenada this weekend if I don't get exercised.
Are you looking for a soul to steal? Are you in a bind? Are you way behind? Are you looking to make a deal?
I might be. What? If you... Okay. Okay. If you have...
Hunji, okay.
Hunji. Okay.
He's slipping into Buddy's patois.
Great podcast. If you had a fiddle, what would it be made of?
If I had a fiddle, well, traditionally, fiddles are made of wood.
No, cold.
Cold wood?
No, cold malleable metals.
Cold malleable metals.
Cold to the touch, warm to the eyes.
Mercury?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
I would make one out of bones, I think, like an exoskeleton.
Okay, I would make a special exception for that.
Okay. That would be a pretty good devil fiddle, I would think. Yes,
think it would be.
Made out of bones.
I think that, you know, I mean, you have skeletons in graveyards who are like pounding on each other to make xylophone sounds.
Do you think that Satan took lessons to learn the violin, or that it just was something that came naturally to him?
That's a good question. Do you think that he prepared himself for this day, should it ever come?
You've got me right here. I know him. I don't know.
That's true.
Yeah, you could ask me.
Did Satan take violin lessons?
Well, I don't know.
You never asked him that?
No, why would I? What a stupid question.
Well, will you ask him when you see him next?
I will do you that.
I guess when one sees someone playing the violin, much like Sherlock Holmes, you wouldn't ask, hey, Sherlock, did you ever take lessons? Because then he would say, no shit, Sherlock.
Well, yeah.
To himself?
Well, is he sort of signing it, like saying, no shit, Sherlock. Sherlock.
Do you think that Sherlock Holmes ever said, no shit, me?
Do you think that those Ewoks at the end of Return of the Jedi took lessons to play stormtrooper helmets?
That's a good question, because they would have to or did they just kind of like futz around with them, or did they already know the instruments that the stormtrooper helmets were based on?
Yeah.
You know, and they just adapted it.
Who set up the fireworks display on Endor at the end when they celebrate
just
their
because they're
victory?
Little tiny Ewoks doesn't mean that, you know, they can't.
But
know how to.
Are there some Ewoks who work with pyrotechnics
and
that's
those
their job?
Come out of the butts of the X-Wing feathers on a flyby.
The
it's
fireworks
true.
Come out of the butts?
Yes. The butts of the dick-shaped X-Wings.
Wait, are you saying that these X-Wing fighters are somehow biological in nature?
Everything mechanical is biological. Everything biological is mechanical.
What about a doorknob?
Yes.
What?
That is a.
This is.
It's a knocker.
This is Satanry.
Call it what you will.
What you're saying is black magicals.
No.
And I don't cotton to it. I don't care for this at all.
Too bad it's coming for you, old man.
What? No. What's this game now?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. We are going to take turns. We will each come up with
that
a...
That seems fair already.
Great.
Very democratic game.
In fact, we'll even go clockwise.
I wouldn't want to go counterclockwise. That's against God.
Yeah. That's satanic. I'll begin... We will each make up the first part of a riddle, just any kind of strange sentence that is a question, and then we'll go counterclockwise, and the other two of us will then try to come up with a joke answer that would be an acceptable riddle answer, and then we'll see who has the best, who creates the best riddle out of this. Does that make sense?
No, let's do it.
All right, here we go. I'll start off. Let's see. Why did the jet fighter crash land his plane in Louisiana?
Because the jet was made of ice and it melted, then you could not see it.
Okay, very good. All right.
Give me the setup again.
Why did the jet fighter crash land his jet in Louisiana?
Why did the jet fighter crash land his jet in Louisiana? Because he...
I got a thing at 12:30.
Needed some cables.
Okay, good.
Oh,
good.
I see what you do.
Yeah, exactly.
I'd like to go again.
Okay, HR, I'll give you a second
shot. Is that allowed? He's a demon.
Well, he's a demon, so we're going counterclockwise back to him.
Ooh, good technicality. You got me there.
Technicality, no down, boo over.
Technicality, no down, boo over.
All right, you want to go get HR?
Don't try any puffin' stuff.
Why did the jet fighter crash his plane into Louisiana?
Yes.
Because... because he was tired and he wanted to do more leans.
To do more leans, meaning leaning down on a bed.
What else could it mean?
I think one lays in a bed. One doesn't lean on a bed.
But if you're tired, I can see the demon's point that if you're tired, you'd rather lean than stand up straight.
And my bed is a hybrid pupa sack that you sort of lean into like a cocoon. It's you. I sleep and take a mood bath at the same time, but it's a standing bath. So you could excuse me my answer for that reason.
Okay. Well, this is all. This is all satanicry out of the Monster Manual by E. Gary Gygax. Mm.
He's a hack.
Remind me, when we play this, do I come up with an answer too? I can't remember.
No, you judge.
Oh, I judge.
No, you come up with one, sure.
Oh, okay.
Why wouldn't you?
Why did the jet fighter crash land his plane in Louisiana? Because he wanted to be by you.
That's the winner.
Wait, so I'm there in Louisiana?
Yes.
Oh, well, that would have been valuable information to have when I was crafting my riddle answer.
I'm sorry, but...
I feel as if you were withholding valuable information so you could win the game.
Okay, so now we all vote, and we can't vote for ourselves.
We all vote?
We all vote, and because there's three of us, we can't all vote right. for ourselves and whoever gets the most votes.
Well, I feel like I have no choice but to vote for you, even though I feel like you play this game very unfairly because I can't vote for a demon.
HR?
Yeah, I vote for you out of sheer... just cleverness, logic, okay. Wonderful job.
Well, congratulations on winning the game that you set up.
And well, we're all going to go now, and whoever has the most points after we all go.
Really
well all right, let's go back to clockwise. HR.
Okay, here's the deal. Imagine, if you will.
Dig, if you will, a picture.
Yeah.
Of you and I engaged in a kiss. Print.
Print?
Print. Isn't that his name?
No, that's something that's on your computer.
Computer?
You don't have a computer?
What are those big boxes with the reel-to-reel tapes?
No.
And,
oh, my God.
Doesn't know what love is?
I've never heard a computer exactly described that
way. Isn't that what it is? It's a machine.
A thing that doesn't know what love
gigantic
is.
Gigantic room-sized machine. You ask it what love is, and then smoke comes out.
All right, HR, what do we have?
So... here's the deal. You're in a room with two doors. Each one has a surgeon guarding it. And the surgeon says, I can't operate on this door. Mm. Why?
Does it go to me?
It goes to you, yes.
Because the other surgeon, the other door, is the one that always lies.
Oh. Okay. Goes to me now?
Clockwise.
Because it's... the one door is not actually a door, it's a jar.
I'm not even going to go.
I want to go again. Okay. Give me the setup again.
Okay, we're going counterclockwise, though. Are you okay with that?
My strength in God is infinite.
Okay, here's the deal. You're in a room, okay? Now, don't worry about how you got in there. Probably you would have had
is this in Louisiana? That's very important to this.
Oh, yes. Where am I?
Louisiana,
on Earth?
Yeah.
Okay.
All riddles take place in Louisiana.
Oh, that's right. I had forgotten that.
Okay. So don't worry about how you got in. You would have presumably had to come in through one of the two doors, which, you know, I got to
okay,
get
let's
my
say I'm not
and...
worried about it.
What if he's a teleporter, though, and he just teleported inside the room?
No.
Is that something Buddy would say?
Perhaps.
That's in Canada. Okay, now please to have a somber attitude towards this as if it were real. You're two guards guarding a door, but two of them are surgeons. And one of them says, I cannot operate
of
on...
of the two, two are surgeons.
Okay. What are you doing?
I'm just trying to make sure I can keep all your demonic details straight.
Okay.
I know you're trying to trick me because of your hellish nature.
No. I just want to play a fun game.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay. No. Okay, here's the deal. Okay. We're in a room.
Two doors.
Oh, God.
Guarded by two surgeons.
I have to start at the beginning every time.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
So they're not guards.
No, they're surgeons.
Or is that their part-time job? Are they moonlighting as guards?
Figure it out,
motherfucker. Some walk by night.
Some fly by day. Moonlighting strangers who just met on the way.
Well, at least we can all agree on that.
Okay, Al Jarreau, Al Stewart are guarding the two doors.
And they're surgeons.
Yes. One of them says, I can't operate on this door.
I didn't know it was Al Jarreau when I made my answer. That's a little, okay, anyway.
Yeah. Why?
Al Jarreau never guards a door, but Al Stewart opens a window.
Every time.
Very good. All right, now you have to answer.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Wait, did you answer?
I did, yeah. It's not a door, it's a jar.
Oh, that's right. Why don't I remember that happening at all?
I don't know. We're all drunk. Are you drunk too?
I might be a little bit.
All right, good.
Okay, here's the deal for the answer.
Okay.
Okay. The Al Jarreau, who else did he sing?
I don't know. What else did he
sing? Morning, Mr. Cheerios.
Jesus.
Big Al Jarreau fan, Reverend?
Moderate. I like those two songs, Theme from Moonlighting and that Good Morning song.
Mm-hmm. Are those the only songs on your iPod?
Yep.
Just shuffle?
That's right. Sometimes I'll play them in order. Sometimes I'll shuffle them around.
Okay. Okay. Okay, for reals. Al Stewart says, I can't open it. Al Jarreau says, I can't open it. Then Al Jolson says, I can't open it. I can't operate on that door. I'm its mammy.
We didn't know Al Jolson was in this room.
No, that, there was another detail that was held back. I don't like the way this
Riddler's
game is being
prerogative.
Played.
Okay, all right.
Riddler's prerogative.
Another great Al Jarreau song.
Riddler's prerogative. Riddler's. Everybody's talking all that mess about me.
Why can't they just let me live?
Riddle.
Riddle. We have to vote. So yes. Let's go to the Reverend.
Well, again, I feel as if my hands are tied and I'm forced to vote for you.
God damn it.
This guy is, you know, he's an evil creature.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh. I'm going to vote for you, Reverend, because I don't think HR's answer really made a lot of sense. And I.
Well, thank you very much. Also, I'm a man of God.
I'm going to abstain and.
You have to vote.
Vote for HR Giger. Oh, no. What do we do with the tie?
Well, you can't vote for yourself, but I guess it's Cake Boss voting for you.
Yeah. How did that ever happen?
Boy, that is a true technicality. No down, boo over.
Technicality, no down, boo over.
Oh, boy. Well, tie goes to me.
Tie goes to the runner. Yeah, it goes to you. Okay, well, all right. So it's 1 point me, 1 point to HR.
Okay. Oh,
I don't like the way this is shaping up at all.
It's your turn, Reverend.
Right, this is like a fiddle off. You better win this. Or you're going to lose it all.
Now,
we're going to have a slime off right after this. So.
Keep in mind that in that song, the devil cheats by bringing an entire band backing him up. That's not fair. That was never part of the agreement.
Have an electric guitar.
You two have, yes. He doesn't even play the fiddle.
Yeah, it's very bizarre.
I have the little river band waiting outside ready to come here.
Well, I've got a big river band.
Oh.
Yeah, I've got the biggest I could find.
I have little feet.
I have big feet.
God damn it.
And Bigfoot.
Oh.
You have Bigfoot?
Yes.
I have a friend who's been searching for him.
Who? Not Gary Marshall.
You know Gary Marshall?
Yes, he doesn't understand all these creatures. God made them.
God
they're
created
creatures
them.
Creatures that didn't make it to the ark. So solitary creatures.
Oh, okay. He doesn't understand
the
this.
They're very sad. He doesn't understand. He's trying to capture them and put them on display.
Oh, that's not right.
They're doing God's work. Bigfoot goes around and he gives children dimes for their lost teeth.
I'll pass that on if you don't mind.
I wish you would.
All right. So
buttons on your overalls.
What do we got?
It is it's my turn to
your
come
turn.
Up with,
yes.
and of course I'll be holding back a detail as you both did.
Okay, good.
That seems only fair. Let me see now. Riddles. Riddles.
Would it help if we played the theme song?
No. I've got one. What have I got in my pocket?
What have you got in your pocket? That's the riddle?
That's my riddle, yes.
Oh. So wait, now, is this the type of riddle where if we guess what's in your pocket, we win what is in your pocket?
Sure.
Oh, okay. I'm going to say your wallet?
I'm going to say nothing.
What do you say?
I've withheld a detail.
What's that?
I don't have any pockets in my clothing.
Oh, man. So
that's
what is
right. They're,
what
stage,
is your, what
they're
is...
stage clothing, so I can write it off.
Are they breakaway?
Yeah,
that's right.
Quick change. Please.
Here we go. And it's just the same clothes underneath.
Oh, my God. So your real clothes are under your breakaway clothes?
That's right.
Oh my
You're
goodness.
Like a holy ordained stripper.
But do those have pockets in them?
No.
This, why not?
This way I can write them off because it's stage clothing.
No, but your real clothes underneath. Do those have pockets
no,
in them?
No, no pockets. I keep everything in my sock.
Aren't you tax exempt already?
Well, I mean, my particular denomination is not, let's say, recognized by the government as a formal religion.
What kind of Protestant are you?
I'm a Lutheranitarian.
Lutheranitarian?
That's right.
A Lutheranitarian?
Lutheranitarian.
Okay, and what do you believe in?
Do you know that TV show Luther?
From Britain?
Yeah.
Starring the dude from The Wire?
That's right. Pretty good show, right?
Not bad.
Well, everything's based on the holy tenets of Luther.
Okay.
I don't know about you.
I don't know about you either.
Well, we'll see.
Ba-do, ba-do, ba-do.
They're known as the couple. The very seldom heard lyrics to the Odd Couple song.
So now...
wherever they would go.
I have to come up with an answer to
that. Yes, you do.
They are known as the couple.
Wherever they would go.
This is just the same...
They are known as the couple.
The same statement over and over again.
Well, he wants to let everyone know that they're known as...
Wherever they go.
They are known as the couple.
Wherever they go to... I don't remember. All right, I have to come up with an answer to what
have
I got.
Now, you have your piece of withheld information, so you could
That's
probably
right. Well, the piece of information I withheld was that I don't have pockets. Right. But I still have to come up with an answer.
My answer riddle. Is still technically correct.
What was your answer again?
Nothing.
Yes, but in order to have nothing in your pockets, you must have a pocket.
Oh, now we are into a physiological debate about God.
You're blowing
God.
My mind, my man.
Yeah. Look, that's what I do is blow minds and save souls. Not in that order.
Based on the TV show.
Also,
Luther.
I came here to chew some bubble gum.
Are you all out of bubble gum, by the
no,
way?
No, I got plenty. I got plenty in my sock.
Okay.
I always have buckets.
One sock I put my cash, the other sock I put my Bazooka Joes.
I'd love to hear some of those riddles, by the way.
Sure,
we're in the middle of Riddle Me This.
Let me just open this up.
Okay, certainly.
That's huge. That is huge.
It's huge.
Oh, I thought that was like a goiter or something. Yeah.
No, it's just a gigantic,
when
gigantic
did they start
piece of Bazooka Joe gun.
Wrapping Bazooka Joe in cardstock.
It's a travel Bazooka Joe, so it lasts longer. It's more protected.
Military grade, World War II ration.
That's right. Yeah. Comes in a little tin.
All right. Let's hear one of these riddles.
Okay. It's one with Bazooka Joe and his friend Mort.
I love Mort.
Mort, of
He's
course.
He's my favorite character.
Has his turtleneck sweater pulled up over his face.
Certainly, as is the style of the day.
Bazooka Joe, child with an eye patch. That's not disturbing. Bazooka Joe says... says to Mort, "Hiya, Mort." Mort says, "Hello there, Bazooka Joe. How have you been?" Bazooka Joe responds in kind, "Well, I've been quite well, thank you, Mort."
They are known as the couple.
Mort says to Bazooka Joe, "Hey, shut up, Bazooka Joe. I've got a riddle for you." Bazooka Joe says, "Well, I don't care for that kind of treatment, but go on, ask your riddle. I'm a patient man."
So these military K-ration Bazooka Joes, they're quite a bit
well,
longer.
Well, you see how much bigger. Look at them.
It's like a scroll.
Exactly, yes. A lot of filler.
Yeah. It's a lot like, you know, certain Sunday papers that have the comics, they have the three extra panels.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So like when you would read Peanuts, if you read the whole thing, just imagine when you're reading a Sunday Peanuts that you can cut the first two panels out.
That's right.
Nothing germane
it's just
to the
small talk.
Yeah, nothing germane to the story is talked about talk. In those.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I remember one where Linus asked Charlie Brown, hey, did you ever find that hat I left at your house?
Did he?
No, he didn't.
And then they got on to the funny part.
Said, keep an eye out for it. Then they got on to the funny part.
Do you think Bazooka Joe has ever asked to keep an eye out on something?
Oh, that's very insensitive. He's a child who lost an eye.
All right. So.
So Mort says to Bazooka Joe, "Hey, Bazooka Joe, when is a little boy and with a cold not a little boy?" And Bazooka Joe says, "I haven't the faintest idea, Mort. I'm afraid you'll have to tell me." That's one whole panel.
Sure.
Then
I noticed there's not enough room for the heads of the characters.
Nope. It's a
the
lot
word
of text.
Balloon is
it's
just...
a lot of text. Then Mort says to Bazooka Joe, "Well, all right, you ignoramus, I will. You should read a book every once in a while." Bazooka Joe says, "That's neither here nor there. Just tell me the answer to the riddle. You started this." Mort says, "Fair enough. I guess I haven't eaten today and my blood sugar's a little low."
And it's just text at this
it's
point.
Just
yeah,
text no,
yeah,
this point.
I noticed it's just a whole
tiny,
page
it's
of
like
just
a yeah, little bit of Mort's hair in the corner, yeah. You can see. So Mort says, final panel, Mort says, remember the question put to Bazooka Joe was, when is a little boy with a cold, not a little boy?
Certainly.
And Bazooka Joe says, Mort says to Bazooka Joe, he says, when he's a little horse.
Oh, okay. Oh, I'm sorry.
He had a sore throat.
Oh, okay. Well, I feel like you would withheld that.
That's Mort withheld that from Bazooka Joe.
Okay, wow. That's how riddles work. All right, now we're getting out of that sub-riddle me this, and now we're back in the real riddle me this. What is your answer?
Riddler. My answer to what have I got in my pockets is a pile of hope.
A pile of hope.
Yeah, that's right.
Pile of hope.
Yes.
Okay. All right, now I guess we have to vote.
We do have to vote. I can't vote for myself.
You can't
vote?
Okay.
So, of course, I vote for yours.
Okay, thank you.
Well, this is a fix.
All right, well, I can't vote for myself. And knowing that HR has a point already, I'm going to vote for you, Reverend.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
All right.
So where does that leave us?
That means, HR, you have to cast the deciding vote. Who will get the point in this particular round of Riddle Me This?
Okay, what's it worth to you guys?
We've never had bartering in the middle of Riddle Me This.
Also, scripture prescribes gambling, so I feel like I can't even participate in this conversation.
Okay, I'll give you whatever's in my pocket.
Okay. Oh, dear. I'm going to give it to you, Reverend, to make it seem like you gambled.
Ooh.
And wear that on your conscience,
ooh,
you silver-dicked jerk.
Well, I have to take that with me forever, wherever I go, knowing that I accidentally sort of had gambling thrust upon me.
Yeah.
Well, the joke's on you. I didn't have anything in my pocket anyway, because I'm wearing breakaway pants.
Oh, wonderful.
With nothing underneath.
Ooh. Oh. Shouldn't have broken them away.
Hey, you know, it's kind of breezy here in the studio, so I don't mind it.
Do you go to Edmonds?
What is Edmonds?
This is where I get my breakaway clothing.
Oh, of course. Yes, yes, yes.
Good stuff.
Very nice. I love Edmond. He's probably my favorite employee.
I can't believe he still works there.
Okay, so to recap, we each have a point.
Oh, dear.
In Riddle Me This.
Three-way tie.
Wow, three-way tie.
Do you know what might break this tie nicely?
What's that?
What if I were to exorcise this demon?
Oh, okay. Why don't we do that? We should close up then Riddle Me This.
Oh, sure.
Okay, so here we go. Let's play the theme song.
Riddler.
Okay. Guys, let's get to this exciting exorcism because I've been hearing about this for what seems like a half hour. Are those clanking chains?
No.
Oh, those are your keys. I thought it was some sort of like Jacob Marley fettered situation.
No, I'm just getting my keys out of the way. Okay. Why would I have clanking chains for an exorcism?
I don't know. All right, here we go. How are we? Do you need any assistance from me?
Yes, I'd like you to shut up.
Well.
Spirit, you are trespassing upon this soul. I abjure thee, vacate this vessel, and banish ye back to hell from whence ye came. By the power of God, the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost, all his saints and apostles, the ground team out there, people on the streets, of course, Rob, Janie, what's that guy's name? Oh, I always forget his name. Victor. Everybody in the whole organization, I banish you to hell. The power of Christ compels you. The power of Christ compels you. The power of Christ compels you. Come on, get out there. Be a sport. Get out of there.
You played into my ultimate plan.
Which is?
Getting me back to hell. I don't want to be here. It's a type of hell as it is. And I gladly go back. All I needed was permission from an official.
Well, have a nice trip and see you next fall of man.
Okay. Before I go, let's be friends and shake hands, okay?
Oh, sure, okay.
Come with me.
What is happening?
See you later, Scott Aukerman.
The Reverend was...
Scott,
buddy, are you back?
What do you mean by back? What happened?
Well, exactly what you thought was happening. Your body was taken over by a spirit.
Did I get possessed?
You got possessed, but...
Oh, I knew it was going to happen someday.
Thankfully, you texted your friend. You were a lot like Texter.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Texter. I love that show.
Yeah. You were possessed, but your friend came by.
The Reverend Persimony?
The Reverend Persimony came in, exercised...
Where is he? I thought he was going to come
demon,
here.
But then it was the strangest thing. He was sucked into your mouth.
What?
He was sucked into your mouth and went down to hell with H.R. Giger.
Are you saying that hell is in my belly? Ega huga.
Is that just something that you're saying with your dialect that I don't understand?
No, I don't know who you're talking about.
Oh, I thought H.R. Hooger was something that you were trying to say. It's a long story. Anyway, I'm glad you're
back. Okay. You know what? I'm not that curious about it.
You know, the listeners heard it. Just go back and listen to the show.
Ugh, like I would ever do that. I do feel a lot better, though.
You do feel good?
Yeah, I feel great.
Okay, well, that's great. Very nice.
Well, I'm not mad at you.
I'm not mad at you.
Why are we yelling?
I don't understand why we're doing this.
I'm just mirroring your energy.
Look, I'm fine with you.
I'm fine with you.
Okay.
You're my best friend.
Oh. What?
Well, nothing.
I'm your best friend.
Forget I said that.
Oh, my gosh. I never knew that you felt that way about me.
I never knew either till just now.
Is that why you're on the show all the time? I mean, you don't have time to be here.
I guess so. I really don't have time to be here, but you got to make time for friends.
Buddy. You truly are my buddy.
I like to be a buddy, Scott.
You're my buddy in two different ways.
First, in that my name is Buddy.
Sure.
I'm the only buddy you know.
Yes.
Secondly, in that I am friends with you.
Oh, we are good friends.
I feel like we are good friends.
Mm-hmm.
What's my wife's name?
Ooh, boy.
Yeah, I thought so.
All right, well,
give my best to cool up.
What is her last name?
Vilayshak.
Where? That's where I'd heard that before.
I held back a detail.
All right.
Wet, wild, all that. Marvelous. Absolutely marvelous.
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 Yes.
You look marvelous.
Hey.
Billy Crystal.
Marvelous.
Kick butt.
Hey, finally, a movie about mom.
May 19.
I'm the cake boss, the boss of cake.
The power of Christ compels you.
What am I going to happen to me again? Hello.
Saludos, my darlings, and you know who you are. Come on, let's mingle. So nice to see you. Throw your hips into the air like Sitchoris and Fred Astaire. Let's crazy go now. Just looking into your eyes, darling, I can tell that you have the legs of a dancer. So bring those legs and the rest of your body over here and be Nando's private prancer. Darling, I got to tell you something. And I don't say this to everybody. You look marvelous. Absolutely marvelous. You know, my dear, my father used to say to me, Nando, don't be a schnook. It's not how you feel. It's how you look. He was marvelous, but you, darling, you look marvelous. Absolutely marvelous. And this is from my heart, which is deep inside my body. It's better to look good than to feel good. Get down!
Fernando!
Darlings?
Who's marvelous?
Try me!
Cindy Lauper?
Marvelous.
Tina Turner?
Still marvelous. These marvelous.
Grace Jones.
Humongous.
Cher.
Marvelous.
Chantecon.
Marvelous.
Vanity.
Marvelous.
Apollonia.
Ditto.
Madonna.
Her belly button is absolutely marvelous. I'm about to lose control, and I think I like it. Oh, look, there's Sting looking for his last name in the dip. I am what love is all about. I've got American teeth and a Spanish mouth. Please, hold me while I tango. So, my dear, it's been a blast. You were not my first, you won't be my last. Ciao! I've got a mambo. Nothing lasts forever, darling. But it's not the end of the world. When I was fired by Paramount, there was still MGM. I love you young people today. With your rock and roll, like a Eddie Van Heflin. Whatever. When I look into your eyes, darling, I see the reflection of me. Look at me dancing around in there. I look marvelous. Absolutely marvelous. There are 8 million stories of the naked city, darling. Let's be two of them. I'm kidding you. I'm a kidder. Let you and I go back to my private hideaway. You'll put on soft music. I'll put on my Spider-Man pajamas. And we'll do things I'm going to tell my friends we did anyway.
Darling, you look marvelous.
Marvelous. Yes. You look marvelous.